In this video, I'm on the Smith River, what I call the Upper Smith River. And what it is the headwaters of Philpott Lake. And this particular stretch is from Iron Bridge Road down to Ryan's Branch, or Union Bridge Road. A lot of pretty scenery along the way. And the mountain laurel was in bloom for the entire trip. It's really cool. But what I did was I time warped the entire trip. It's about 14 miles. I included most of the river footage because I didn't know what to not include. I mean, it's so pretty. Look at that mountain laurel. This cool rock feature. I don't know what that's called, but if anyone that watches this knows what that big rock feature there is called, please comment and let me know. But I think I said when it was 14 miles, I included most of the river footage. I think my camera screwed up and didn't save a couple runs of time warp. But overall it's there, but it's just a very beautiful river. Fishing was meh, but the river was gorgeous. So there's about four falls on this river. The largest one is White Falls, which is at the very end of the run. Here we're coming up on the first set of falls. And there's another one of the larger sets is called Black Falls. I'm not exactly sure which, because there's two. This fall here is a pretty good size. It was enough water and rocks in there to where I just felt like it wasn't worth trying to go through it. The scale of the falls, any video you watch, the scale of the water never transfers. It always looks way worse in person. So I just went around this one. And that is my first trout, rainbow. But first trout, never caught a trout until then. I'm actually real proud of it. You don't see a lot of trout from kayaks for some reason. I think, at least not here where I'm from, you see guys catch them wading. So, I don't know, pretty cool. Right here, I let him go and he went belly up. I guess I handled him too much. So I jumped out, scooped him with the net, and trying to help revive him right here, holding him in the current, putting him upstream. And he was breathing, and he recovered, and then he went, shot right up under my kayak, and he would not leave from under there. He loved it. See? Right into the kayak. It's really cool to watch that fish. Beautiful fish. So he looked good to go, so moved on. Right here, you can really see the mountain laurel on the hillside. I timed the trip just right. Then the laurel was in bloom, in full bloom, and it was mountain laurel in bloom everywhere. In some places, there would be, these beautiful mountain laurel flowers floating on the water. It was really pretty. Alright, we're at the next set of falls. I think this may be Black Falls, but I'm not 100% sure, so maybe someone can chime in on that. Again, it looks way worse in real life than what it looks like right here. I mean, don't get me wrong, you could go over this in a kayak, but in my big fishing kayak with all my gear, by myself, middle of nowhere, don't know anyone, just won't work it, so it's just so easy to get around it. So. This rock bass, that's a nailer rock bass. I mean, I don't know that I've ever caught one bigger than that. I've caught a few that's right at that size. But you can look at his little mouth there. He's a nice one. They're pretty fish. And aggressive little suckers. So coming up right here, I'm gonna run into a black bear. It's a lot closer than the camera shows. Whip out the phone, trying to video him. Guys, that is a black bear.
Where is he at? I wish the scale and impressiveness of White Falls translated better on video. It's a lot bigger, a lot more impressive than what it looks like here. It's one of my most favorite places I've ever been on a kayak. It's beautiful. And this is the view from camp and the hammock, actually. So I'm laying in the hammock right here. If you look real close at this walleye, he's deformed. I'm not sure what the deal is with that. If someone knows, maybe it's some type of birth defect or something. But comment and let me know if you have an idea on what causes that. And that made the fifth species of fish for this trip. This is Blue Falls, which is actually on the lake part, so we're on the lake now. And you can get it here by boat or kayak. It's a very short paddle from the launch to this, actually. So we're only maybe a mile and a half now from the takeout. And here we go. This is the end of the trip. It was beautiful. The night before the trip, we stayed at a really cool Airbnb. When I got there, they had biscuits and honey waiting on the table for us and blueberries for the picking. I mean, it was great. A very peaceful experience. I really enjoy that place. I think I'll be back.